I swear you'll never see anything like this ever again. So watch it. Drink it in. Stupendous. The greatest moment I've seen.
Big underwear here tonight to lead you in this Footy Fetish concert. Is your opening act. It's more like a reminder. All right, guys. Don't go chasing feeding frogs. Please stick to the assists and the goals that you're used to. I know you're gonna say Messi or Ronnie's the greatest of all, but Haaland keeps scoring so fast. Welcome back to the Footy Fetish Show, where the fetish is real, the footy is soccer, and our son, everything revolves around a foot and a ball. Sometimes they're kicked so hard, the balls go right in your mouth, and sometimes they go in the goal. We fill your goals and fill those holes, your balls and feet. Ladies and gents, we always love to cover some Champions League. It's our specialty. It's our forte. And today, cook up a little special round final eight. Get the final eight on our hands. What better way to break it down and to bring on some folks and to do it with the eighth wonder of the world, Mr. Oak.
Yeah! So back on the mic! Get the mic back. As always, pleasure. Love getting my little intro in. Mic back.
Of course.
Why don't you kick us off, introduce one of our guests. Who we got in the chat with us?
Well, first, I think we got to break down one of our repeat offenders. Mr. Pretty Boy Parker, say what's up.
Yo, yo, what's up?
We're going to introduce our next guest all the way from Hotlanta. Welcome back to the show, Gunner Mike. Gunner Mike, how are you?
Fellas, how y'all doing? Y'all hanging in there?
Time. Pleasure to have you back on. And we've got a third guest as well. Not the least, but the last. Welcome back, Super Mario. How are you?
Hello. How you doing?
Welcome. And for those who don't know, these two fans, we've got two Bayern Munich pundits as well as a Arsenal supporter, our Man City fans. Booty, how would you describe our Man City fans when we asked them to get on the show? Would you say timid is accurate?
I think this one, man, this has all the makings. This little matchup we got in our hands here against Bayern, I think it's got them a little scared. I would be too. It's got all the makings of a final written all over it. That's what you love about Champions League, right?
That's actually a really great point. This definitely is final worthy. These two teams are top of their domestic leagues. They've been dominating throughout the Champions League as well, scoring boatloads of goals. It's going to be a very exciting game. I am absolutely thrilled.
I think we should do a little something special for this little matchup, don't you think?
Absolutely. But before we do that, let's just quickly go through the schedule. We've got four games this week coming up. Tomorrow, Tuesday, we've got April 11th. We've got Benfica hosting Inter. Manchester City is hosting Bayern Munich. And then off on Wednesday, what do we got, Big Underwear?
Wednesday. Some team named AC Milan. I'm not sure if you heard about them, Hugh. They wear the red and the black like the Falcons. Versus Napoli. What a Serie A showdown that's going to be. Mm-hmm. Oh, boy. And then we have Real Madrid versus Chelsea. Prayers up for Chelsea, y'all. I know we make fun of them a lot on the show, but that might be a little rough. But that's, as my friend Chris Berman used to say, that is why they play the game. So we'll find out on Wednesday.
So let's quickly go back to Tuesday. We're going to go around the room, get everybody's predictions, add a little bit of a hot take, maybe a spicy take that you think might happen during any of these games. So let's go back to Tuesday, April 11th. We've got Benfica hosting Inter. I'm going to pass it off to Gunner Mike. Gunner Mike, who do you have winning this one?
I got Benfica. They've just done really well. They've lost two games in their league this year. Just a solid group, and they seem to have a good thing going. So I'm going to rock out with them. Especially, I think you said they're at home,
that's
too, right? Yeah, yeah, let's run
all
it.
Right. Hosting in Portugal, Super Mario. Who you got winning this one? Or are you dropping a draw?
Oh, that's a good question. A draw does sounds probable, highly probable, but I really do think Benfica is going to take this home game because they have a lot to fight for, you know?
Heard that. Parker, what you got, buddy? You're the betting master.
Can y'all hear me now?
It's a little in and out, but just go for it.
All right. Well, I'm going to say I think Benfica squeaks it out here. I agree with everybody. I think they're the better side. I feel they're going to play, I guess, a better defensive scheme that Inter will have to try to break down. So I'm going to give Benfica the edge here.
Okay. And big underwear. Do you think Inter have the underwear, the package to fill their underwear? Or is Benfica going to drop a draw with? I'm trying to make the underwear puns, and I'm really struggling here.
I'll tell you what. The weirdest thing I've seen in a long time, the other day I saw some guy who makes fake dicks. It's for transgenders. I don't think he can make a dick big enough for Inter to fill any kind of underwear for him. No offense to my Serie A boys. I've been liking Benfica for a hot minute. Just really fun to watch. Hey, I've said this on the last couple episodes too.
Yeah, yeah.
Man, you could go back to last year. They've been impressive, man. Showing up and giving Liverpool a fight last year,
yeah.
In the knockout stages. And then on the flip side, you got Inter, who kind of weren't very impressive against Porto last round. They're coming up against a very impressive another Portuguese side. Who has the firepower to score some goals. I'm going to go old-fashioned and take this team who likes to score. I'm going to take Benfica. When it comes to those betting odds, I'll throw out here real quick. Plus 115 for Benfica, plus 230 on a draw, plus 250 for Inter. This is one of those matches I suggest going for one of those little player side bets. Those little player props. I would go with a João Mario shot on goal if he is in.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely, he's going to pepper the net a little bit. So that's a good one to always throw a couple bucks on. I got to give Pretty Boy Parker a little credit on that. A couple weeks ago, he had brought that one up, and I was just like, man, what a fucking that's a killer right there, man. That's one you got to feel he's going to get at least a shot on goal. So I'm going to throw that one on up to you. Your turn, Ocho. Something, who are you taking? You sticking with your Serie A boys?
I actually kind of want to go with a draw. Something I want to point out here, and I just remember this. Porto actually beat Benfica over the weekend in Benfica. It makes you wonder, is Benfica already looking ahead to the Champions League, and they're kind of pumping the brakes a little bit? If we look over in their league right now, I believe Benfica is clear ahead of everyone. Yeah, they're clear ahead. So they didn't really care about losing that game. I have a feeling they rested some starters and didn't really stress too much about this. But just something to keep in mind, a player that I really like for Benfica that's not really talked about enough is Florentino. I forget his first name, but he's a young player, center defensive mid. He's very wiry, long. Look for him to really make an impact and take advantage of the stage. Not to mention, Booty had shouted out João Mario. And then, of course, the hat-trick hero from the World Cup, Gonçalo Ramos. He is always a threat in front of the net. I think he's only 21, 22 right now. So it's going to be interesting to see how this Benfica team goes up against this very experienced and tough opponent. Inter is no joke.
Yeah, they won.
What's that?
They won over the weekend, I believe.
Inter drew.
Oh, drew. I'm sorry.
Inter drew. Thank God against Salernitana. That was awesome. The Serie A gods were looking down on AC Milan as they also drew. I'm gonna go with a draw. I'm gonna drop my draw here, and just a little piece of history. The last time these two teams played in a European tournament was in 2004.
Wow.
Incredible. Wow. They did play in an international friendly in 2008, but the last time this game actually really mattered, or the last time this matchup really mattered, was all the way back in 2004, and it looked like it was a Europa game. So this should be interesting. These teams have not seen each other in a very long time. Booty, do you want to go through this next matchup we got on Tuesday, or should we save it for last?
We will save that one for last. Right. To close out what you were saying, man, it'll be interesting to compare the lineups for Benfica between last game and this game we're going to see tomorrow. So
definitely
keep your eye on that.
For sure.
But yeah, let's jump into Wednesday. Let's go with your boys, dude. Let's go with your boys. AC Milan against the big giants in Italy right now, Napoli. Oh, boy. Now, I think we should pass it to Hugh first, okay? But before I do, let me give you a couple odds here. It was pretty even. We got AC Milan plus 180. We got Napoli plus 170. 210 on a draw. Very close. Bookies don't even really know what's going on here. They don't know which way to lean here. So, Ocho, you know, AC Milan and Napoli actually just matched up recently. Tell the boys what happened. I know you're going to get into that first. So, please, take it away.
So, first off, 4-0 victory, AC Milan in the Maradona. An incredible showing from AC Milan. But a little caveat to point out is that the Napoli fans were very disgusted at the management of Napoli. Napoli raised their ticket prices from €25 to about €90.
Wow.
For this Champions League matchup. And the Napoli fans are saying, we're literally playing the same game we would be playing in a week. Why are you multiplying the price by three? So they rioted, they protested, they did not support Napoli inside the stadium. And as y'all know, AC Milan travels very well. And they took full advantage of that. And throughout the game, you could hear the AC Milan supporters very clearly. And I think not having that counter presence inside an away stadium really played a part there. With that being said, this first game is going to be in San Siro. It's going to be in AC Milan Stadium. So I think that really will play a big part. Not to mention we're starting to find our form again, which is really nice. And I'm not sure if Osimhen is going to be healthy for this game. He has missed the last two that Napoli have had. So he's a very big piece for them because he challenges those center backs. And if they don't have somebody that's challenging those center backs, that's forcing them to sit back on their heels, then I really think that takes a big piece away. Tavares Scalia is always a challenge, but we were able to neutralize him in that 4-0 victory. And you can't blame the fans not being there for that. You know, he has got to be able to show up on his own without fans. So with that being said, I think we can walk away with a win here. I think we get those 3 points and we head over to the Maradona for the second leg. I'm going to pass it back to you, Booty. What do you got?
Very interesting. I like your point too, man. A lot of folks didn't realize this last match. No Osimhen, probably been the biggest guy they have, biggest threat they have up top. Man, it's tough. My gut tells me a draw. You always feel like, you know, especially after the last, you know, like you said, there's a beat down, right? You know, Napoli doesn't want to, you know, come out flat on this one. But at the same time, we got two legs to play here. So I feel like this is one of those ones that if Osimhen doesn't play, Napoli just tries to just get out of there with a draw. If I was going to bet on it, there's a double chance possibility. I would take, if Osimhen plays, I'd take Napoli or the draw. Whereas you could pick both of them for you folks out there who don't know. But if he doesn't play, man, that's a tough one. That's tough. But I'm going to stick with a draw. I'm going to drop my big underwear draws. And I think we need to pass it to Super Mario next.
Man, Arsenal and Napoli. If Osimhen misses out this upcoming game, I believe AC Milan will take it. At least nice little 3-1 win. I think so.
All right, I'll take that and run with it.
Yeah.
Parker, who you got?
I don't know if I have a winner of this as much as I am kind of just going with some betting tips here. So I've heard the, you know, draw. I've heard the draw, no bet, double chance. But I'm leaning under here. I think Osimhen out gives them a hard time to finish, not only having him finish, but opening it up to other players to score. And then we've all seen AC Milan's recent offensive woes, even against subpar teams. So,
well,
you put them
in. I mean, the only woe is not in the back of the net. But if you look at the overall attack, the attack is there. It's just, how about this? Do you anticipate Napoli parking the bus?
You know, potentially, I think they could, if Osimhen's out and they want to park the bus away and get back home. You know, what better way to go home? 0-0, hopeful that Osimhen comes back. You know, what do you want? You want to come out and get exposed and go down another 4-0? So I don't think we see a high scoring game here. I think it's, you know, Napoli plays conservative. I think they'll take what they can get, you know. Obviously, AC Milan will push a little bit here and try to get goals. You know, I sent you those stats from this past weekend. I mean, dominated possession, you know, double-digit shots, single-digit shots on goal. So, I mean, like you said, the production's there. They're trying. They're pushing. It's just, you know, and they did that against, you know, a non-top tier club,
right?
There.
The
so
quality of the team was shit for sure. I mean, not shit, yeah. But they're not relegation,
right?
But they're bottom of the table.
It's no Napoli.
They're not Napoli, which is ironic because we can beat Napoli 4-0 and then we can't fucking beat Empoli, you know, at all, which is just, and this is my point, is that when we play against teams that park the bus, we fucking struggle. I don't know what it is. We can get the ball in the attacking third. We can create a whole bunch of shots. They might not be on target, but the shots are there. And then we can't finish the game off. So, you know, if Napoli parks the bus, then we might be in for a long day.
Yeah, so it's kind of tough for me to pick a side. You know, if I do like, you know, if I'd say a 1-1 draw if I had to pick something. What you got, Mike?
That's fair. Gunner Mike, what you got?
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of on board with you guys as far as if Osimhen doesn't play, just as far as what it takes from them on the field, mentally, if you don't have them out there, you know, that throws everything off. So if that's the case, I mean, I definitely got to go with Milan to get the job done. But if he does play, then I'm rolling with Napoli for sure. So that's kind of where I'm at with it.
The latest reports are saying that Osimhen missed the training today and that he will get evaluated tomorrow to see whether or not he can play. I'd be willing to bet you're right, Parker, and that they don't risk him because they're already so far ahead in Serie A. There's no need to push him back there. And if they can sit back and park the bus and have success there, then they get Osimhen back in the second leg at home, different ball game, anything's possible. So definitely could see that game script going down for sure, for sure. But moving on, Booty, why don't you get us going for the next game on Wednesday? What we got?
Oh, boy. This one, ladies and gents. As my Chelsea lovers that listen to us already know how much I make fun of Chelsea, and no offense, I love all of you, but goddamn, I'm betting everything on this one. Real Madrid, Chelsea. I already said on the other episodes, I'm done betting against Real Madrid, dude. I will bet them until, like, every time I bet against them, folks, they lean me over, like it's prom night and I'm the virgin. We ain't doing it no more. I'm sticking with Real Madrid all day. I already put money down on a Benzema hat trick. It's going to get weird.
Damn.
Okay? I'm going to straight up just go ahead and give mine. I'm going to pass it to you. We're going Real Madrid. It's at Madrid. We are fucking – I'm sticking with that. I don't care if how many legs it is, anything. At this point, Real Madrid is now out of La Liga. I think we can all agree. So what do they do whenever they're out of La Liga, right? Put all the rotten eggs in one basket. And that basket is Champions League. So I don't care who's playing for them. I don't care what the lineup is. It's just – it is their tournament always. I finally – it's taken me probably over 10 years to finally just get off my horse and fucking admit it. So many beatdowns from them. I was their version a few times. You know what I mean? I felt it. I felt the Real Madrid dick. I'm on it. I'm on it. So I have Real Madrid to win on multiple parlays, which is already bad that I'm telling all this. It means I've already lost. And I threw, hey, odds 25 plus 2,500 on a Benzema hat trick. I think that's generous, to be honest with you lately. He's had two hat tricks this month, if I believe, or at least in the last few weeks. Either him or Vinicius Jr., hey, throw some dollars on that for a goal. I'm loving it, man. Give me Real Madrid. In case you didn't know, I'm loving Real Madrid. Do I even need to say why I'm not taking Chelsea? Or is that like understood? you know what I mean? Like, come the fuck on, man. Like, they literally went out and got the girl back that they broke up with, called her late night, like, hey, you still up? He said yes. Like, who we're talking about a dude who's been fired from them, fired from another team in the same league this year to come be an interim coach. Do I even need to say Frankie Fever, okay? What is going on, dude? That's like weirder shit than you know, some crazy shit Juventus pulls half the time, you know, where, oh, yeah, y'all fucking fix some games again. I just can't even explain it, dude. I need like an EPL master to tell me what the hell's up with that one, but man,
I feel like at this point, Frank just claims he, you know, people say, hey, you used to play soccer, right? He's probably, yeah, I used to play for Man City.
It's just baffling. It's baffling, man. Like, how much money was spent and no results, and you think that the guy that you fired previously is going to fix this, and oh yeah, you only have like this amount of time to do it as well, and they're just firing you again.
I'm gonna play devil's advocate here and just remind everyone what happened last time they brought in a manager late in the season. Tommy Tuchel, right? Uh-huh. Was able to turn that shit around, win a Champions League out of nowhere. Granted, he did have the benefit of going up against a Pep Guardiola who probably overthought the final there. I remember specifically the lineup being unusual. I think he only went with one center defensive mid, and Chelsea was able to exploit that. But is Frank Lampard Tommy Tuchel? Absolutely not. To kind of just break down the mistakes of Chelsea, I think Todd Boehly is playing too much FIFA and hasn't really thought about the psychology of bringing in all of these younger players and hoping that they all just kind of work. One of them's Ukrainian, one of them's Portuguese, one of them's from Argentina. So right there, you've already got three players that speak three different languages that are not English.
Right.
And then you bring them in yep, to a coach who's hella English, probably got a really thick accent. I don't know what Graham Potter sounds like, but I could just imagine the stereotype of his name being – I can imagine all of these things being very difficult, not to mention – you have an American manager who thinks that a 4-4-3 is a soccer formation, right? So you've got all these little pieces here. And I mean, we had Matty Stats on the show, and he highlighted it great. He's, you know, it's the inexperience. All of this youth coming together from all of these different parts of the world. I think this is what's causing them. Hopefully Frank Lampard can kind of return the identity back to him. That being said, you've got fucking Carlo Ancelotti, a prime Benzema, a prime Modric and a prime Vinicius just hosting this battered and beaten Chelsea team. This is gonna be this is gonna be embarrassing. They might park the bus. We might see Chelsea park the bus.
Like the old days.
Shit, man. It's gonna be bad. Let's pass it around the room. Gunnar Mike, what you got here?
I definitely have Madrid winning the game. Champions League is kind of their thing. Always producing, always getting results, but I am not going to act like Chelsea doesn't have talent on their team and that they can't necessarily turn up on their day. Young and inexperienced talent turns into experienced talent, at a certain point. Not saying it's going to happen now or whatever, but, they got guys. So, it may be a battle to a degree, but definitely got Madrid coming out on top. But I'm not sure if it's just going to be a shellacking or, beat down or whatever, but we'll see.
All right, I'm going to pass you one. Over, under, 3.5 goals.
Under in the under. Game.
Do you think a 3-goal or less? Parker, yeah. Parker's giving me a negative. You think under 3.5 goals? All right, Mario, give us your prediction. Oh, sorry, Parker, go ahead.
I would say I agree. I think it goes under. I don't think it's going to be as a straightforward win. I tend to see these lines of I think Madrid's a minus 140 favorite. And, I notice this all the time. A team that you think is going to roll and with a line like that tends to be a little closer than you think. And that's Vegas, who knows everything, talking. So I still think, they get away with a win here. I could, as a bet, I would probably say Benzema score and Madrid to win. I don't think it's in hat trick fashion. I would say maybe a 2-0 win for Madrid. One team scoring goals, one team isn't. That's just, what it boils down to here. And Chelsea's just a team of a puzzle that hasn't quite fit together yet. There's another team out there that I've been on this pod and I've talked about before. They used to play in Champions League. They used to play in Europa League. They tied their league game today. That team is Barcelona.
Which is crazy because they're in first place in La Liga. So does that mean they're a good team or that La Liga is shit, right? It's like, how do you make sense of that? Like, they're clearly in first
place. I think they're just prioritizing. They came in, they said, look, for the team that we have to win something. So they can't win UCL. They can't win Europa. They're balls to the wall. No excuses. They have to win something.
Right. Yeah, that's fair. That's fair. I believe Mario is the last one. Mario, who you have winning and over under 3.5 goals?
I'm going to start with over under. I would say 3 goals. I see Vinicius, Benzema, and Rodrigo scoring. I think Madrid's going to take this game and the leg, both legs. The first game's in Madrid, correct?
Yes.
All right, yeah. And I'm pretty sure Rudiger is not going to play because I think the tradition or the culture with the Spanish teams wouldn't let their player they just bought play their former team, But I believe David Alaba is back, started and played the whole game, and Real Madrid's back line is gonna keep Joao Felix and company silent, So Real Madrid winning this game for sure.
something to point out, Real Madrid also lost their game over the weekend.
Yeah.
We haven't seen that Matthews, that Chuck Woese pulled off in the box. Woo!
Crazy.
It's clinical, man. I teach that to nine-year-olds. Ah, such a good move. Such a good move. Inside, outside. I think that'll do it for our predictions for Real Madrid and Chelsea. Booty, is there another... Is there another one, another game we got to talk about? I can't remember.
I think so. Let's take a look. It's about that time. We're about to roll it out. Let's roll it out, baby. All right. So here's how we're going to do it. We're going to go down. Do we have – let's see. So we have – I'm going to still ask the questions to Gunnar Mike, too. He's got to answer. He's got to go ahead and answer. I'll tell you what. Gunnar Mike is going to answer – at least one City question, but he's going to have to answer all the Bayern questions. Is that cool with you?
Yeah, that works, man. That works.
Sweet.
Be a good sport, man.
Because I understand. I just probably jinxed all my bets and probably Real Madrid just now. Chelsea's probably going to come out and win like 4-0. I understand. You don't want to jinx you guys. I get it. So with that being said, I think let's jump in. I'm going to bring up the questions. Four. The infamous. This will be the most infamous. Hopefully, this will be the best game, at least in our minds. Manchester City, Bayern Munich. Hopefully, this will be the best one of this round. We'll find out. Let me pull up these questions. All right, I got them ready. Now, gentlemen, it's going to be. I think you know what we're going to do, Ocho. We're going to need you to be the judge. You're going to keep score here.
Okay.
All right. We're going to have a slew, okay, of – we're going to have a couple true-false. We're going to have some over-unders. The over-unders aren't going to count for points, though. The true-false will.
Well, we do a post-game add points to, like, make it up.
Of course.
Okay.
Of course. We'll do that.
Lock that in.
I do have a multiple-choice question in there, too. And I'm going to be that second judge that tells you what the right answers are. And again, all these answers – or questions, excuse me, they are based on fact, okay? It's very important you understand that. So without further ado, I'm going to give you guys the first one. All right. The first one is going to be a City question. We have City questions. We have Bayern questions. We're going to go around the room here. All right. Super Mario, you're first. First City question, true or false, all of City's entire three-person fan base will be in attendance here at home?
True.
This is true. They will be. All right. Gunnar Mike, this is going to be the one question. Actually, no, we're going to save. I got a better one for you to answer. You're not answering that one. Parker, true or false? We lose Parker again?
I missed it. Go again.
True or false? All of City's three-person fan base will be in attendance for this whole matchup.
True.
Beautiful. Yes. I think they're going to have a hell of a showing. All right. It is true. So both these gentlemen have a point.
It's a tie game so far. 1-1.
It's a tie so far. All right. Pretty Boy Parker is going to kick off the Bayern questions. Over under 10 minutes into the match until Tommy Tuchel finally realizes and gets his manhood back after Conte almost whooped his ass. True or false?
False. You can't get back what you never had.
Beautiful answer. Super Mario, what you got?
I would also say false.
And Gunner Mike.
False as well, man. I'm stamping it.
I also thought this was a false. We're going to give everybody a point here again. Nice. I only thought it because it might have taken him maybe 20 to 30 minutes, but I like Parker's answer best. Give Parker an extra point for that. That was a beautiful answer.
Right, 3 points.
That's 3 points for him right there out of 2 questions. My man's killing it. All right. Back to City. Over or under? 2.5 shots on goal for Holland. Mario.
I say over.
He's taking the over.
Is this on goal or just shots total?
These are all. It has to be on goal.
Okay.
Yes. Think about that, Mario. Think for a second. You might have 10 shots, but one on goal.
I'll say right at two, you know, at the most.
So Mario's going to go with the under. So keep this in mind. He is one we have to check back on later.
Got it.
Yeah.
Gunner Mike, go ahead.
So it was 2.5?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm going over.
Woo-hoo. Nice. And Pretty Boy Parker, if you were to put money on this right now, what you feeling?
I don't only have Haaland getting 2 shots on goal. I have him scoring 2 of those goals.
Oh, damn. Parker's going up again, adding another point. This is just...
That's beautiful. That's beautiful.
Anyone want to take that 2-goal bet? Anyone?
Oh.
Anyone?
Okay. I would not disagree with that.
All right.
Well, man, he's on fire.
So you have Haaland scoring 2 goals against your own team?
Yeah.
You hear that? I mean, hey, man, that's smart betting right there. You're not betting with your heart. That's... I respect
you
that.
You can't. That's where people fuck up.
I feel you, bro. This is why I don't bet. Too passionate. Wear my heart on my sleeve. Can't do it.
Hey, that's where I'm at too, man. I can't even bet against that. I don't want to. I don't want to take the bet.
I'm going to let you know. So just a little story time. My biggest betting with my heart, not literally, is thinking that Brazil could have beaten Germany in that 2014 World Cup.
Damn.
Walking out at halftime. Just with my head absolutely, you know, in my hands. I'm so glad I wasn't into betting back then. That was just – I really thought they could do it. I really thought they could pull it off. Genuinely thought they could pull it off.
Oh, without those 2 players?
3.
3.
People forget the third, bro.
Who's the third? Can you remind me?
Is Neymar, Thiago Silva.
Right.
Dani Alves.
Huh.
Starting right back, captain, leader, Barcelona. Come on, bro.
Who started at right back?
Danny. Oh, like Maicon or.
Oh, Maicon. Okay.
Somebody like that, like old, like washed up Maicon. Okay. Not Inter Maicon.
Right.
Hey, if it makes you feel better, man, I think if anybody came up to me before that match and said this game's gonna end 7-1. I would tell them to take a fucking hike and go fly kite. Like, so if that makes you feel better, I don't think the world saw that.
I'm a big Brazil fan. Fuck that.
5-0 in the first 25 minutes.
That shit made me sad. I watched the whole game too.
I couldn't do it. Couldn't do it.
Yeah, dude, that's tough to watch that whole one. Shit. I was glad I had to work that day. At first, I'm like, oh, man, I wanted to see that. And I saw on TV at work, and I was like, oh, I'm glad I'm working. Okay, well, anyway, we got to go back to Bayern now. So let's start it off with Pretty Boy Parker this time. Since you're in the betting mood, you're down to throw out, you know, Haaland's going to have 2 goals. Who's going to score first for Bayern?
That's tough.
That's tough.
We know they're getting one, right?
Yeah.
Who's
they're
it
getting
be?
One? You know, it's always a crapshoot, but I almost feel like it's. I mean, Coman's our guy, right?
Mark him down. Mark him down, Hugh.
King Kingsley.
The king, baby. Mario, who you got?
The first person to score for Bayern Munich. Man. I would love to see a center back score a goal, but I would say Jamal, if he starts. And if he doesn't start, I will go for X-Man City player Leroy Sané.
That's a nice one there. That's a little sleeper. I like it.
I got to add one. I'm going to throw him the Licht, man. He's been scoring some sneaky goals lately.
Him and Upa. Him and Upa been killing it. And Bavard, bro.
Yeah.
Upa Meccano.
Bavard,
my guy. Free Upa Meccano.
Free Upa Meccano, man. Still need him at the
He's still locked up.
That hashtag is at least 3 years old.
That's my guy still, man. Love that guy.
Every time I see that guy, I automatically think, free Upa Meccano. like if I'm looking at the score sheet, you know, I mean, free Upa Meccano. So, Mike, are you going with Upa Meccano?
hey, I was actually going to go Musiala. I think I like that kid. I think, you know, if he starts, I think he'll be that guy. If not, you know, I love my boy Serge still. You know, it'd be cool to see him, you know, get some shit going. But I like Musiala. Seems like a big game kind of guy. So
I love the answers to this question, because the reason I really wanted to ask it is because every time I always feel like I'm watching a Bayern game or I'm looking at the score sheet later on, it's always somebody different that contributes. So that's a really cool answer from all you guys. Can't wait to see who it is. We got to go back to City real quick and like a real City question here. All right. After, let's see. Okay, here we go. Bayern, City, or a draw for the halftime result? Kick it off with Gunner Mike real quick.
Bayern City or halftime result? I'm actually going Bayern to be up at half.
Okay.
Yeah.
Mario, who you got?
Wow. I say 1-1.
1-1, so a draw. Okay. Parker.
City lead at half.
City lead at half. All right. Ocho, you throwing one out there?
Yeah, I got City leading at half as well.
City leading at half. Beautiful. Beautiful.
dropped into our, by the way, why aren't we discussing Arsenal being a fresh breath of air for the game of football? When was the last time a team so pleasant to watch? Shout out.
Bring this guy on. Bring this guy on, man.
Gunnar might need to answer this question.
Hey.
Get this guy on here.
Wait. We're talking about Champions League.
I like the football.
Hey, you'll see us next year. We'll be in there next year.
That's right.
Gunner Mike has been just holding his tongue this whole podcast.
I'm being humble, man. Look, I'm being humble, man. We ain't got nothing going on. We ain't in this shit. So, you know, we're chilling on the sidelines. But we'll be there next year.
So I'll let y'all know, this is the president of Crescent City Football Club. Parker, you might know him. John Rednauer. He was in the soccer world.
Yeah, we crossed paths with the Baton Rouge team for a bit.
There you go. Yeah, that's right. Anyway, just had to drop that comment for Gunner Mike there.
What's up, Jonathan?
And then Mario. You know Jonathan as well. Man. That's right.
What's up, Jonathan? What's up, bro?
All right. Yeah, all right, Arsenal's playing beautiful soccer.
They are, man.
And, that
was a rough one yesterday, but we'll get to that. Maybe we'll get to it. Or we don't want to talk about it.
We can talk about it. I want to talk about it.
Oh, we put.
I need to vent.
I was gonna say we got your shout outs coming up, and we'll have to force you to discuss this as your shout out. Like no, there's no backing out of that one.
And look, I've been sipping this Woodford. I'm down for any City question, man. Run it.
All right, let's finish up our little game show here, so because I'm now excited to hear about Arsenal. Jonathan, you know, created a fucking monster here, dude. Or actually, the monster was already here. His name is Gunner Mike. But anyway, the whiskey created the monster here. All right. Here we go. We got to go back to Bayern. Parker, it's no secret that Neuer is afraid to stay in goal. What did the goal do to him? Multiple choice question. A, steal his lunch money. B, give him a swirly. C, fuck his mom. Or D, The Rock says, know your fucking role, jabroni.
I'm going to go non-consensual sex with his mother.
Okay. All right. Mario, what you got?
I'll say, know your role, jabroni.
And Mike, what you got?
whatever the other alternative was.
Read it back again. Let's hear those again.
We got A, steal his lunch money, which is just a fucked up move if you're, you know, trying to get lunch real quick, you know. B, give him a swirly, which damn that motherfucker would have to be big. But the goal is bigger than Neuer, I guess, right? C, fuck his mom, which, I mean, if Stifler's mom can be fucked, all moms can be fucked. And D, The Rock says know your fucking role, jabroni.
Yeah, I'm going to go with the lunch money, man. I'm going to go with the lunch money.
Lunch money?
Yeah.
Oh, shit, you want to take a guess as well?
I like the swirly, man. I'll bring it around and get the last one. I'll take the swirly, dude.
Like, is there anything more disrespectful than a swirly? I mean, Jesus Christ, that is is awful.
I don't know how you don't kick out of that or something. I mean, but then again, he's a goalie, so maybe he could, you know what I mean?
Not the most athletic, you know?
No, but that's why the answer is D. The Rock says, no, you're fucking rolled, jabroni. Stay in the fucking goal. Yeah. All right. Point to Mario. All right. Now we got to go back to City. Now this is a gem one right here. True or false? And I'm down to share my screen really quick. We're going to do that before I do this.
Let me stop. I'll get you a roll.
Okay. All right. Here we go. All right, here we go. True or false, Keira Knightley's character in Bend It Like Beckham is actually Jack Grealish. Gunner Mike, let's start it off with you since you're the EPL man. What you think?
You know. Sure.
Oh, hold on.
I can't ever get it out of my head now that I've seen this picture. For you folks at home that are listening, we have a picture up of this.
This is my first time seeing this.
I think we found Jack's inspiration.
Yes.
This may be it.
This, yeah, I was, you know. Mario, what do you think?
I said true.
True? Parker? I already know it's a true from you.
I mean, it's right there.
It's right there. Give them all points, Hugh. Give them all points. It's right there.
It's amazing.
I mean, they're both looking hot, aren't they? I mean, come on. I bet you that dude shaves his legs too. Anyway, now let's stop sharing this screen right there. We back. What we got for you here? Let's close it out. This will be the last one right here. Y'all got to give me a final score of this match. Who wins? Who loses? What you got? Let's kick it off. Mario, you go first.
All right. I want it to be Bayern Munich 2-1.
2-1 Bayern Munich. Got it.
I'm writing these down.
Gunner Mike.
Man. Like, I last thing I ever want to do is discount Bayern's European pedigree. They get it done every time. They're giants. We all know it. City is just on a kind of roll right now. We can see it. We've all seen it last couple of weeks. What are we going on? I don't know how many matches it is in a row now. They're just, you know, kind of steamrolling here. So I'm going 2-1 City. But I am not discounting Bayern to take the whole thing as far as, you know, the overall tie. But at this moment, yeah, I got to go. Got to go with City.
And last but not least, tell us what that score will be, Bayern Parker.
So Tommy comes in, beat City 1-0. City 0 trophies, the ones that matter. Both teams, you know, pretty healthy here. I think Bayern has a slightly bigger injury list, but nonetheless, you know, quality starting lineup.
I like it. One thing I'm going to throw out there that we all should probably, you know, on a serious note, actually pay attention to: if Bayern can get past this round into the next round, of course, once we hit that final four, you know, we're talking some serious giants there. But if we look at the road that Bayern's taken up to this point, they've had PSG, then they would have had City. Hey, it's something that we should keep an eye on.
Winner of Real Madrid or Chelsea?
Yeah, right, man. Yeah. It's, I mean, yeah. And it's only going to get harder. So
yeah.
That's why we love this league.
A great chance for a Serie A team in the final. That's all I'm going to say.
Yes, indeed.
Opportunities.
But hey, my prediction, which I never gave, 2-1 City.
2-1 City, baby. So we got a 2-1 Bayern and a 2-1 City. Love it.
I think this could get out of hand. I think this could really get out of hand. As long as De Bruyne is on the field and as long as Haaland is on the field, there will be goals. That's just facts. As long as those two are on the field together, there will be goals for City. It's going to be a matter of if Bayern can keep up with the scoring back and forth. I think both teams even out in their back lines. I think they're both quality back lines. I think Cancelo is definitely going to be highly motivated to perform. Is he injured or is he healthy?
He's healthy, but I don't see him starting.
That's a damn shame.
Hey,
going back to the psychology of players here, this is when you put a player on the field regardless of their form. This is a match that's going to flip a switch.
You think so, Hugh?
100%.
Who's he better than, though?
I would put him over Pavard.
Hey, he's a goal scorer, baby.
So is Cancelo, bro.
They both are, but...
Sometimes.
I don't know.
He's going to be super motivated.
I think they both are. You know, Pavard, I'm sure he's been going off at practice and the games and whatnot. And I, for some reason, I'm going with Pavard. But I think Cancelo has a little slightly more discipline, as in not getting yellow cards, but not discipline in position as Pavard. But. You know,
how about this? I got a question for you. Do you think Cancelo can handle the pressure from the City crowd? Because you know,
yeah, you're right.
That's going to be a problem. If he can handle that psychological, some players, they take that energy and they use it and they flip it against the script.
Right.
Some players crumble and can't handle that shit. Like Cristiano Ronaldo. He fucking loves that shit. Zlatan absolutely loves that kind of pressure. Does Cancelo have that type of mentality? Can he take it? Parker's shaking his head. I don't know. I'm just like, that's something to be aware of. If I'm the Bayern Munich coach, you have to be aware of Cancelo's mentality and his psychology. Is he going to be able to control his emotions? Is he going to be able to maintain his composure in a tackle? I don't know, but... It's a big risk, big reward type of play, in my opinion. I'm the type of coach, I'm playing that guy. I'm playing him. But that's me. So
it's a big moment to let the dog off the leash. You know?
I'm so excited to watch this midfield battle, though.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Even get to the midfield, they're even. I'd say Kimmich and De Bruyne are like for like, in my opinion.
Damn. I think one's better defensively, but
that's where I'm going.
Yeah.
One is clearly De Bruyne is clearly a better attacking player. I think we can all agree there. But I think Kimmich's engine and soccer IQ on the defensive side of the ball is better than De Bruyne, and I think those two cancel each other out in the midfield. We'll see. That's just my opinion. Then you start to go down the list. So Musiala, who is going to be matched up with Musiala? Is Gundogan, is he in the lineup? I don't even know who's their starting midfield right now.
Yeah. I think, that's tough.
Yeah, we'll have to see if Pep overthinks this, too.
Absolutely. And that's absolutely in the cards.
He just might.
That's in the cards, for sure.
That was one of the questions I meant to ask. You know, after the 5-0 City victory, how many times is Pep going to overthink it in the second leg, you know? And they lose 6-5, you know? but With that being said, before we move on and close this one out, just throwing this out there, if we're talking about the betting odds, City's favored, almost kind of disrespectful in a way. They're favored negative 140, plus 300 on a draw, plus 360 for Bayern Munich. A little, man, I would have thought maybe like plus 200, maybe even less than that. I don't know, plus 115, plus 120, I don't know. But plus 360, man, that's a hell of a bet to just throw $5 on or something, you know.
I'd take that bet.
Yeah, throw it in a parlay, you know. I'd take that bet, too.
I still think City wins.
Vegas is sneaky, man.
We're gonna find out, man. It's going to be interesting. As Tuchel has played against Pep many times. He knows the schemes. He knows what Pep likes to do. But that being said, I was just looking over at Pep overthought and actually has a really solid formation here. I don't know if y'all have seen this. It's a 3-2-4-1. Mm. Very unique. I've never seen this run before. Have you guys seen this happen?
It looks a little like a spider web to me.
Yeah.
So Pep's already overthinking it. Awesome.
But I mean, this formation, 1-4-1. Granted, it's against Southampton.
Literally the bottom
of the barrel,
like the last team in the league.
So this is
a test drive.
Yeah, I would agree. We got a comment. Oh, never mind. Promotion. It's a stupid promotion.
Ah, boo. Boo.
Boo! Get off the channel. We don't like your kind around here.
We are a sponsored by Trash Water. We don't need you.
I got Trash Water too.
Uh-oh. That natty light.
Yeah, I think this formation is just to keep possession and get the ball to Haaland.
Yeah. It's against a low block team.
Yeah. There's going to be a lot of crossing in the game, and good thing De Ligt and Upa and even Pavard can definitely prevent those things from happening. But, Upa, World Cup finalist. Pavard as well. I mean, he won a World Cup already. De Ligt, you know, young guy with a lot of experience under his belt, and I think they feed off of that. And Alphonso Davies, you know, as well, dude's a monster.
I got a player that we're not thinking of that I'm excited to see.
Mane?
Jan Sommer.
Ooh.
Oh. Yeah, you're right.
At goalkeepers, I feel like Ederson is such a liability.
The good thing, he's played against Haaland before, and, you know, he knows what to tell the other players. Oh, you know.
Interesting. He's got the experience of Haaland in the Bundesliga.
Correct.
X factor. All right.
Knows the language, if there is going to be a some sort of language, but it's going to be universal English. But it's going to be a good matchup, you know.
I'm excited.
Can I tell you my starting lineup for Bayern Munich?
Go for it.
Jan Sommer, Alphonso Davies, De Ligt, Upa, and Pavard in the back. Goretzka, Kimmich, double pivoting in the mid with Tuchel's probably going to put as much firepower as possible. So probably going to be Thomas Müller up top as a 9. Sané in the 10. Coleman on the right or left, and Mane up top as well, because experience of English teams as well, you know, he's played at Man City Stadium so much time, so-and-so, and and then Jamal and maybe at halftime to just add an extra spurt of energy.
What is that formation? I tried
4-2-3-1.
4-2-3-1. Okay. So your three is going to be is it Coleman,
Sané,
Coleman, Sané, and
Mane? Mane, yes, sir.
And then Mueller is on top of them.
Correct.
Interesting.
As an interchangeable
false nine.
Correct. You know, Mane is going to jump in that nine. You know, so it's possible. So that's my if I was Tuchel, I would love to see that on the as an option. So
interesting. All right, I can dig it.
It's that German formation, baby.
That's right. 4-2-3-1.
And to close this one out, I mean, Q, basically you're saying, you said Ederson was a liability. So basically you're saying that the goal fucked his mom. So, with that being said,
all of the above.
Let's yeah, probably, but and gave him a fucking swirly. Bet over 2.5 goals on this one, ladies and gentlemen. That's what we're gonna leave it at. There are goal scorers out there. If it don't fucking happen, then come kick me in the nuts. I've been kicked before. It's time to close this one out, don't you think, Coach?
Hell yeah!
It's been a fun one.
Mm-hmm.
I think we should do this for every round from here on out in the future. Every round that has a really spicy matchup.
Yeah.
Sometimes we'll have to flip a coin because there's multiple spicy matchups, yeah. You know? It's just whoever has fucked the other one's mom a little harder. That's the one we'll go with. It's time to give that shout out to all the people that we love, all the people we hate, Stifler's mom, whatever. Let's see. Who wants to take it away first? Anyone? I'll give it up.
Give it to me.
Who wants it?
I've been thinking about who this all day.
Go ahead, boo.
All right. I want to shout out. He got so much hate. The team got so much hate. Management got so much hate for this move. Ben Foster showed up today, blocked the game tying penalty for Wrexham to get the dub on their way to that title.
Did they win it?
They won that game off of a sick last-minute Ben Foster PK save. You got to look it up. It was nice. And but at 40 years old, a guy that, you know, has gone through it, played at the highest levels, played Premier League, finds his way, ends up on Wrexham, gets shit from everybody. You know, you could go and look at all the negative press they got for this move, and then that game was today. It was crazy.
I was actually just putting in the comments, Ocho, it's actually on our story right now if you go look. 96 minute.
That's crazy.
Makes the save of his life. Beautiful fucking shout out, Parker. Love that one.
So they haven't gotten promotion yet, but they're one step closer because of Ben fucking Foster.
It's only one position I'm seeing. Or maybe the top team automatically gets it, and then the other teams have to go to a playoff. Is that how it works?
Yeah, I think with that low, it's like one. Just you got to win.
Just fucking win.
It looks so. I'm looking at it. The first place team automatically gets a promotion, and then the next six teams are in a promotion qualification. So. They're 3 points clear, second place right now. And they have, let's see, how many matches left? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 left. Wow. I need to go watch that series. I'm going to give a shout out to Rob McElhaney and, what's his name? Ryan, I'm drawing a blank.
Yeah.
Ryan Reynolds.
I was going to say Ryan Gosling, but I knew that wasn't it. Give a shout out to those guys for getting involved into European soccer and showing a side that most Americans are probably not even aware of. Just this third division.
You know what I heard?
What's up?
I heard Ryan Reynolds sold his New York home and bought a 1.5 million home 5 miles from the stadium. And he's moving there with Blake Lively. He's fully invested.
Wait, say that. I missed. You cut out a little bit. Say that one more time.
Ryan Reynolds sold his New York home, bought a home, 5 miles from the Wrexham Stadium, moving there with his family. He's all in.
What? That's a dream, man.
He's all in.
I'd fucking kill my heartbeat if I had that kind of dough.
Yeah, no, it's cool. Hilarious. Like all the, I'm looking at all the comments made when they signed Ben Foster too. Be so funny if an 8-week PR signing who hadn't trained for 10 months comes in and costs them promotion. I am very surprised that a 39-year-old retired goalkeeper turned YouTuber isn't that good.
Wow. About to make up some money.
Shout out to Ben Foster, man. Going to be in the championship, man. Love to see that.
That's fucking awesome.
Pass it over. I'm going to go Super Mario. We're going to save Gunner Mike for last because I want to hear... I want to just vent, man. I just want to hear Mike Gunner Mike vent. So Super Mario, who's your shout out today?
Man, I didn't really think about that, but just the people at Crimson that's involved with the Crimson City Classic and how organized it was, and it was a good time. That's all I'm gonna say. That's on top of my head.
Before you go, do you remember your place? You remember where you placed?
Yeah, I got it right here. Yeah. So I didn't get the top 500, to say the least.
Damn.
But my minute was, I finished 48 minutes and 42 seconds. I have at a 7:50 pace. In my overall, nice. I finished 779 out of 10,239 people. So.
Damn, dude, you were fucking booking it, man.
That's pretty good, man. That's a lot of people.
Yeah, first time doing it, and it was good.
How you feeling?
It's all about that time, dude.
Nice, man.
Nice.
Change my shout out to Mario.
Yeah.
7 minute miles on this.
Damn, great shout out, Mario. Fucking right.
Yeah. That was cool.
All right, Booty. Go ahead, man.
Man, yeah, no, dude, that was awesome. If the word seven is mentioned in your mile pace, I used to be a cross country runner, so that's freaking great. Okay. Then I got fat.
Yeah, hey, I worked.
Then I got fat and just didn't care. I'll tell you what. Let me give a shout out. I hate to make things a little serious here. I'll give you all a serious one. I had a weird week last week here at Camp Booty. I lost two friends, one of which, and neither of them totally related or anything. But shout out to Justin Ty, old friend of mine I used to work with. Fortunately, just had a rough battle with cancer, it was pretty quick. So I just want to shout out to him and his family. He's a very good guy to me. Very good man. Crazy motherfucker. And used to work with him hand in hand for about a year. And he was very influential to me and my wife when we used to work together. And it's a really, really tough way to see a young guy go, early 50s. So I wish him and his family the best if somehow they end up hearing this. But he's actually a big inspiration on the route I took career-wise today. So he taught me everything I knew, and he was a very good guy. And also shout out to Tyler Schmidt. He was a gentleman who we were going to get in the podcast for a long time, but he was a big Messi guy. I was a big Ronaldo guy, so we always kind of butted heads, but very good guy. Unfortunately, we lost him a little too early. He was around our age, so... really sucks. So I really, again, hope him and his family the best as well, if they somehow get to hear this. But he was a big soccer guy, big Barcelona fan, even though we'd make him fun of Barcelona for a while. And I would always make fun of him because of Barcelona. So he definitely knows I'm still up there. You know, he's up there and I'm still making fun of Barcelona. So shout out to those two guys. Again, I hate to, you know, make it put it on a you know, sad note there, but two big guys who definitely enjoyed some sport, enjoyed some footy, no longer with us, but I think we got one left now that we need to definitely turn our attention to brighten some spirits here. Gunner Mike, Can you tell us why we aren't discussing Arsenal being a breath of fresh air? For the game of football and for Jonathan?
All right, so first shout out. I got to give a shout out to my daughter. She's turning one in about like 2 days.
Wow.
My first kid, so big shout out to her. You know, my biggest blessing, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, yeah, shout out to her. But as far as these Gunners, man, shout out to the boys, man. Like, shout out to the boys. Like I was saying before this shit kicked off, if you asked me before the match if I would have took a point at Anfield, I'm taking that shit 10 out of 10 times. The boys have passed every test so far. They're doing the business. And then, like, yo, I'm hearing all kind of shit, man. People talking about Man City is weak. Man City is not weak. Man City is not weak at all. We balling. They balling, too. And they got a good team. They got a great team. So I don't want to hear nothing about the Man City that they drop in. None of that. I'm hearing stuff like, oh, Arsenal is a fluke. They ain't one-hit wonder. They ain't going nowhere. It's a young team, youngest team in the league. Where do they think we going? Where we going? This shit here to stay. UCL, we coming. We going to be battling for the league, too. And what have I said for the years now? Coming on this pod. Your favorite player won't come to Arsenal. I don't give a fuck about what you got to say. Your favorite player won't come to Arsenal, man. It's a fact, man. It's true, man. Just watch. You'll see it all take shape. Declan Rice coming soon. You know, we're making it do what it do, man. Shout out to the boys, man.
I got a question for Teacher, man. I got a question. Could you give us a rundown? What is the remaining schedule looking like? Do you know?
Tough games. So we got West Ham and I think Southampton are our next two. And then we got a nice little run-in after that. I think City, Newcastle, and Chelsea are like three back-to-back-to-back games. That's going to be the season right there. I believe that's what's going on. If I'm right here, it looks like he was pulling it up right here for me.
Well, West Ham should be a win.
I'm hoping.
Yep.
They still got quality. That's the thing about the league. It's just quality everywhere. Where like,
yep.
And then the thing is, right now we're the hunted. They haven't been in this position before. They don't know this type of feeling. So I need Arteta to, I don't know. He's been in these kind of locker rooms with City, because it wasn't with us. We weren't winning shit when he was playing with us, except FA Cups. So this is a whole different type of thing he's dealing with right now as a manager. Just gotta rein him in. Just gotta rein him in.
You're gonna win now.
I need it, man. I need it. I need it bad. But, you know, if you ask me before the season, I picked Liverpool to win the league on this pod when the season first started. Really? And we see how that shit going. I did. So, you know, I had no idea this was coming. But we've come this far. I want to see it all the way through. But, you know, we'll see how it goes. But, yeah, I know I got a little excited there. But, you know, shout out to the guys, man. We'll see
how.
That's
why you're on the pod. We want to see that excitement. So, if we're looking at the table, the points. So you guys are 6 points ahead, right?
Yeah.
Right, you are six.
But they got a game in hand.
They do have. Oh shit.
That's where it gets.
So let's assume it's three. So
right.
You guys basically have to win out. So West Ham. Yeah. Should be cake. Southampton should be cake. This game is going to essentially determine the league right here.
Oh.
That's it, man.
What day is that on? Yeah.
This is on the 26th of April.
Oh, man. Is that a Thursday?
It is during the week, I think.
Why the fuck would they do that to us?
Yeah, I don't know why they're
damn,
doing that shit.
It's fucking Wednesday.
It's fucking dumb.
Yeah, because this game originally was a different date, and they pushed that shit back type deal. So I think it's why it's in the middle of the week right now. But And plus, City just has a lot of games at the moment.
Yeah,
I mean,
that's right.
They could really ideally still, I think, get the triple or the quadruple still. I'm not sure if they've been knocked out of yet, honestly. So
these three right here are going to be the biggest test for Arsenal, because Chelsea would love nothing better than to fuck up their rival town team from winning the league. Newcastle, They're trying to be in Champions League, straight up. Right. So they're going to try and get points regardless. They're also at home. And then Brighton are just a tough team. At least you guys finish with Nottingham and Wolverhampton. But, I mean, you guys have a string of four games here where...
It's a tough run-in, man. That's a tough run-in against.
These are the games you win to win the league. Realistically,
I agree, man.
You could probably get 7 to 9 points there.
Like, what we really need, I think, just to even get this, we're going to need City to drop somewhere. They're going to have to drop somewhere. If I'm just being real about it, that's the only way it's going to happen besides us playing them. They're going to have to drop. Now, this is where, and I'm sorry for, you know, my guys, my Bayern Munich guys. It would benefit me greatly.
I know where you're going.
If Man City advanced and had to concentrate more on the Champions League, because they've never won it. They've been here, done that shit with the league. But, you know, Bayern Munich, tough test. I'm not sure that's going to happen.
I'll compromise. We'll just hurt Haaland for you.
Hey, you know what? I can live with
Please don't do that.
I can live with that.
I own Haaland. I'm invested financially in Haaland. I need him to be as healthy as possible.
But I mean, City's got tough games too.
Bayern, two out of the next three. That's just miserable. And then you got Brighton, Arsenal, and then they're
Fulham's no joke, honestly.
Yeah, all right.
They've fallen off a little bit here in the last couple of weeks, but just within the league, I mean,
Chelsea could also fuck City up here, second to last game of the season. I mean, if you're a team like Chelsea, you've lost.
And look at that last game. Brentford. Ivan Toney and the boys.
Brentford fuck around?
Brentford's not bad.
Top nine. Okay. Oh, shit. They're in contention for Europa.
And look at Fulham right behind them. You know what I'm saying? So, you know.
Yeah, Chelsea. But it's City. Chelsea is absolutely in contention for a Europa League spot. Oh, but actually, it kind of Tottenham to Villa. That's quite a big separation there.
Man, can we talk about Tottenham for a minute?
Yeah, go ahead.
Because if you could hear the kind of shit I was hearing when they hired Conte and they're going to be this, they're going to be that, they definitely win a trophy. Can we talk about the serial winners who have come to Tottenham and still have failed? Come on, man. Mourinho, you fired him before a final. Mm. And then you got Conte in there, still ain't winning shit. Come on, man. History of Spurs. What my man Mourinho said, football heritage, man. This is Spurs, man. This is what's going on. But hopefully Harry Kane leaves. I've been hearing the Bayern rumors with Harry Kane. I've seen that a time or two, even since last summer.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Maybe Parker can expand on that more. I'm not sure if he's seen that too, but, you know.
Give me Kola Moani.
That's who you want?
Yeah, he's a stud.
He is a stud, but he's just, I mean, it's like, for me, it's like
in the future.
Or João Felix or Enzo Fernandez. Like, they're young, they're hot now, but.
Overpriced?
I think he's
going to. Don't work well together?
He's going to be.
Lose games? Yeah, I want those guys.
I don't know. Yep. I think you could probably do better with Harry Kane, but I'm with you. Both of them are going to be at a high cost. Kola Muani is in the Bundesliga, so, I mean, man, that's actually not a bad idea.
I'm okay. Has some French connection.
That's right, the French connection. Parker's got to share. We have to be careful sharing clips like this. We might get kicked off of Facebook.
Oh, man.
I've had this happen.
Oh, wow, bro. Wow, bro.
I just had to humble you real quick.
Yeah.
Hey, look, and that's fair. I've had a lot of, y'all, you know, had some rough times against Bayern Munich. A lot of 5-0s, 5-1s. I think y'all got us like 10-2 on aggregate more than once.
It's a lot of ammo. It's a lot of ammo.
Yeah. You
know. Bayern loves to beat up
on them. Arsenal's my EPL team right now. They, you know, Easter, everyone, he has risen. They talk about Easter, I'm talking about Jesus.
It was ironic he scored that goal.
On Easter Sunday.
Yeah.
That's right.
damn, all this time I thought, or people were saying, I thought it was like an Easter porn. He has risen. It's a dad joke if you're not a dad, you know. We should close this out before we end up putting bets down who's going to win EPL. I'm also five trash waters deep. This is a good ending point. But, you know, before I start, you know, trading dynasty picks and stuff.
I'm intrigued.
Yep. Yeah. I mean, I'm awake for a little bit. I still got to eat dinner. But we wanted to thank you guys. We love our repeat offenders, of course. Love you guys. Mario probably doesn't remember, but the last time I think I saw him in person, or maybe like the time before, he was waking me up at his house because I was super drunk. We were doing the breaking the seal when you guys lived together, Ocho.
Wow.
And I woke up on his couch and I was just like, what happened? And I remember just like thinking, like, you're going to sound like such a fucking rookie fucking virgin because you drank like a whole bottle of whiskey. And I was just like, what happened? Just my fiance? No, it was fiance then too. And you were like, it's okay, bro. It's okay. It's the next day. And I was like, oh shit.
Yeah, that was wild. I remember that. We had a podcast that we had to record that morning as well at a studio.
Man, I felt so embarrassed. I just like fell asleep on somebody I barely knew's couch. And I was like, man, I'm so sorry. It was Woodford. It was Woodford, Mike. It was Woodford. And I remember just being like, dude, what? Like waking up and being like, where am I? What happened? And like Mario's talking to me, it like clicked. I was like, oh, shit. I'm so sorry.
It's not cool. I mean, at the time, I thought it was still cool. You know, all good.
As long as I didn't break anything, man, or cost you any money.
No, not at all. Date. Yeah. Nobody. Remember those two girls fighting over one guy?
No.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, man.
I didn't remember much that day. But I'll tell you what, I do remember you guys coming on. Appreciate taking the time out your schedule. I know it's tough. I know it's fun, you know, to talk footy, but it's also tough. All of us getting old as fuck now. So, thank you guys. Appreciate y'all. Please come on back and join us anytime. Y'all are always welcome. Ocho, do you have anything else?
That's it, man. Excited for champs tomorrow.
Yeah.
I am excited. Please, on Wednesday, please blow my phone up with how much money I'm going to lose. It'll be great.
Oh, man.
And then I'll hate Real Madrid some fucking more. I have a Zidane jersey that I'm going to wear as an undershirt to work. They're not even going to know. It's going to feel so right. I will have it. I have a friend of mine. There's something not here. He's probably not listening now, thank God, or else I'll have to hear this later. Ocho already knows who it is. There's something just not, it just doesn't click. And it's one day he's like, I'm getting rid of these jerseys. And he gave me this jersey and I was like, what is this bullshit he's giving me? It's a Don jersey. We're going to fucking wear it on Wednesday. We're going to do it. Benzema hat trick. This has been the Footy Fetish Show where the fetish is real and the footy soccer. Peace out, Boy Scouts.
Nice. Peace.
Y'all hang tight. Don't go anywhere.